always feel happy.
দিন ওটা আমি ধরি এটা ধরবে দিন চলুন ওই বৃন্দাবন প্রভু বললো আপনাকে নিয়ে যেতে আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে আমি নিয়ে নিচ্ছি যে দিচ্ছে হ্যাঁ এটা গুরু মহারাজের ঘরে দিতে বলেছে আপনাকে একটু দর্শন করছে বাইরের লোকরা বিদেশে আমাকে বলেছিল অনেকদিন দেখেনি আপনাকে তারা পড়বেন আপনি না না এই জৈব ধর্মটা পড়বেন আপনি এইটা পড়বেন আপনি Maharaj is saying that now I have become old. Before when I was young, I was having so much power and strength.
to perform any kind of service in Hari Bhajan. But now I am already 90 years old and I am losing all enthusiasm, strength and power to perform any kind of service. Maharaj is saying this is like time and nobody can do anything to the time. Nobody can do anything with the time which is passing on. Forget about humans. Even the demigods and the demons also, they cannot do anything. So only the surrendered souls who have submitted or surrendered themselves unto the lotus feet of Krishna and have sincerely performed devotion without any deviation, only they will be able to cross the time. Only that time, what will happen, only to those devotees who are sincere, only to them they can suppress time. So Maharaj is telling that only death is always running after us, always chasing us. So we cannot escape from death, but only the one who are surrendered, sincere, and have completely surrendered themselves unto the lotus feet of Krishna, only they will be able to, death will not come to them. They are not fear of death as well. So the surrendered souls, they are never fear of death. So we should all try to follow the footsteps of those previous acharyas and try to surrender ourselves unto the lotus feet of Krishna. Complete surrender. The devotees, they don't die. The devotees, they don't die. But with our material eyes, we can see that they are also leaving their body. So many sadhus we have seen, the previous acharyas, they have also died. But the devotees, they never die. So Maharaj here is giving an example. Like Maharaj is telling, at the time of winter you cannot see the snakes outside. The snakes that time stay in their holes, in their nest, and after the winter is over, when they come outside in the light, outside from their nest, that time what they do, they leave their skin and the actual snake. Actual snake comes out and they leave their skin. So same like that, the devotees, by the order of the Lord, these devotees, these pure devotees of the Lord, they come to this material world by the order of Supreme Lord to rescue the fallen souls. So when their work is over, they leave their this material body, and with the transcendental body they go back to their transcendental abode. So it is like the same of the snake leaving his skin. They have accepted the material body just to come to this world to rescue the fallen souls.
Sadhana program
So Maharaj is also giving a very nice example. He is saying that what happens when there is a play goes on, that different people takes the role of different persons. Some becomes Ram, some becomes Lakshman, some becomes Sita. So once the play is over, they change all their clothes and they become ordinary person. So it's like that. The pure devotee is the messenger of the Lord, as they are come to this material world to rescue the fallen souls. So for that they have to accept this material body. And once they have rescued everything, once their work is done here, by the order of the Supreme Lord, they go back to Golok Vrindavan by leaving this material body. So it's just a covering, or it's just a ornament that they accept when they have to come to this material world. Otherwise, the devotees, they never die. There is no death for the devotees.
তার আগে সবাই পালন করছিল কারণ সেই পথের তুলল কেউ আর তাকে
মানুষ ছিল। So the Maharaj is telling that when the play was going on, everybody was paying their obeisances to that person when he was dressed as Ram, Lakshman or Sita. So once the play is over, when they have changed their clothes, will all that person again will pay obeisances to that person? No, because he has already changed his clothes. When he was playing the role of Ram, that time people was having some feeling inside their heart and they were paying obeisances to him. And once he changed his clothes and once he has come back to his original form, that time then nobody was coming and paying him obeisances. So before also he was an ordinary person, and also while doing the play also he was ordinary person, but he was doing the play of Ramchandra as a king, and after the play also he was that ordinary person. And even after leaving the clothes also he will remain the same. But the pure devotees of the Lord, they never die. Whatever they were before coming to this material world, they were the same, and what they are when they have come to this material, and even after leaving this material body, this material world, what they were before, they will be like that only. There will be no change. They are the messengers of the Lord. So this is the difference between the materialistic people and the devotees of the Lord. So this is a very subtle understanding. Those who are serving Supreme Lord, those who are doing Hari Bhajan, and those who are not doing Hari Bhajan, those who are averse to Krishna, this is the difference. For materialistic people, there is death, and for the devotees, there is no death. Anik. So that's why. So Maharaj is telling that Supreme Lord is one, and different religions of there are different religions, and people are addressing that same Supreme Lord in different names. But everybody is serving Supreme Lord, trying to serve in Supreme Lord, staying in different religions. So Maharaj is saying if the one is not serving Supreme Lord, he will always remain unhappy, he will always have problem in his life, and he will be poor as always. Those who are staying in the forest, those who have no education, no etiquettes, they think the big trees of the forest or the stones of the forest as the sign of Supreme Lord, and they serve those big stones and trees in the forest, thinking that as the sign of Supreme Lord. So everybody here is trying to surrender themselves according to their capacity to the feet of Supreme Lord. So the Supreme Lord is our ultimate shelter. He gives shelter to everyone. And if you take shelter to some ordinary persons who will not be able to rescue himself, then what he in which way he will rescue you? So if you will take shelter to an ordinary person, it will not bring any welfare to you. So Maharaj just came downstairs, he did parikrama and he was sitting. So I thought let's hear some Harikatha from his mouth. So probably we will be having a class with Maharaj on Tuesday in the evening. I will update in the post. And Maharaj also said that if you have any questions, you can write. He will definitely go through your questions and will answer you. Hare Krishna. Onek jayga ache. চলুন আপনি উপরে যাবেন তো উপরে যাবেন আপনি উপরে চলে যান
হবে ভালোই হবে ওর কমার্স কমার্স মিলে না, তিনজনে খালি আর্ট মিলা
বেকার বাত
একজন মাস্টার আসছিল মাঝে মাঝে আসলো আমার তিন স্কুলে হাই স্কুলের তিনজন মাস্টার আসেন
এখানে অনেক বাংলা মিডিয়াম আছে স্টুডেন্ট অনেক কম হ্যাঁ সব ইংলিশ মিডিয়ামে ঢুকছে বসে বসে মাইনে পাচ্ছে আর কি করবে
এখন সব ওই পাবলিকে ঘুরতে হচ্ছে
হ্যাঁ মানে স্টুডেন্ট অনেক আছে যেরকম ওই বালিগঞ্জ গভর্নমেন্ট হাই স্কুল তারপরে এদিকে আরো অনেক মানে কেন্দ্রীয় যে স্কুলগুলো আছে কেন্দ্রে হ্যাঁ সেগুলোতে খুব কম এখানে খুব স্টুডেন্ট কম আছে আর এখানে টিচার গুলো সব আসে মাঝে মাঝে হ্যাঁ রামপুর আসে রামপুর যায়
স্কুল
ওই চাঁদা কালেকশনের জন্য ওরা এসে প্রসাদ পায় চার পাঁচটা স্টুডেন্ট আছে
মহারাজ
টাকার খেল যে বেশি টাকাতে অ্যাডমিশন নিতে পারবে সেই স্কুলের নাম বেশি। সরকারি স্কুলে তো 300-400 টাকার মধ্যে হয়ে যায় সারা বছরে, হ্যাঁ খুব জোর হলে 500-600 টাকা। আর প্রাইভেট তো ঢুকলে 50,000 টাকা ভর্তি, হ্যাঁ ভর্তি করতে হবে 50,000 টাকা মিনিমাম, তার মধ্যে মাসে মাসে 2,000-2,500 টাকা মাসে মাসে ফিজ আছে। ওগুলো ওই স্কুলগুলোর নাম বেশি, পড়াশোনা হোক না হোক নামটা আছে ওই তো।
কার্মেল বাবা নব নালন্দা, এত বলতে গিয়ে জড়িয়ে মরিয়ে অশ্বিনী দত্ত কি
মাঝে মাঝে ব্যবস্থা করতে।